This is how your GTX 1660 Super might run Cyberpunk 2077 if you have chosen their own video settings. And this is how your GTX 1660 Super will run Cyberpunk 2077 if you choose the correct ones. In this video, I'm offering you a quick optimization guide on how you can combine optimal graphics fidelity with the highest possible performance, free of frame stutters or screen tearing. Before we proceed to that, I have to mention first my gaming setup, that is built upon a Ryzen 9 3900X installed on an MSI B450M motherboard. Admittedly, not the fastest, neither the sluggiest hardware for today's standards. The 32GB RAM are recommended, but not necessary, especially if you don't run heavy applications in the background while you are gaming. Cyberpunk 2077 is a GPU-demanding game, however, there are some settings like the crowd density that utilize heavily your CPU also. If your system has a much weaker CPU or you are using a hard disk drive instead of an SSD, then consider to decrease the crowd density and choose the appropriate setting on the HDD mode accordingly to your hardware. One last important thing you have to do is to install all the applications I'm using in the present optimization tutorial. List of the software along with the corresponding download links you can find in the description below. Without any further ado, let's jump into the first thing you have to do, and that is a quick Windows optimization that applies on both Windows 11 and 10. Installing the latest NVIDIA drivers for your GTX 1660 Super is extremely important. To see if you have the most updated NVIDIA drivers, open the NVIDIA control panel and click the home icon. Take a look at the current version of your GPU drivers. To find out if you have the most recent drivers, open your browser and go to the NVIDIA's official website. On the driver's download page, make the appropriate selections that match to the GTX 1660 Super card and your corresponding operating system. If the found drivers match those of your computer, then you are good to go. Otherwise, press the download button and follow the automatic installation procedure. If in the past you had different NVIDIA or AMD graphics cards installed on your PC, then I suggest you to download and use the Display and Driver Installer application. These will clean permanently any older driver and system files that might conflict with your recently installed GPU. Link about it you can find in the description below. Now let's hit the Windows search box and type in Game Mode Settings. Select the Appearance setting and in the new window, enable it. Underneath that, click the Graphics button, or if you have Windows 10, type in the search box Graphics Settings. From there, select Cyberpunk 2077. Hit Options and select High Performance. Leave the rest as it is and press Save. Back to the search box. Type Edit Power Plan. Click on the corresponding field. From there, you want to use either High Performance or AMD Ryzen High Performance if you have an AMD Ryzen CPU. In the event that none of these options are selected, go to the Power options and select the corresponding setting. It is always recommended to free up as much resources as possible by disabling or closing unwanted applications and processes running in the background while you are gaming. A first step to do that is through the startup apps of the Task Manager. There are plenty more complex optimizing Windows configurations that you can play with, but this is not the scope of the current content. Which brings us to the NVIDIA's control panel. Click on 3D Settings menu and go to Adjust Image Settings with Preview. And then select Use Adjust Image Settings. Then click on the Take Me There field or alternatively on Manage 3D Settings and select the Program Settings tab. Make sure that the selected program is the Cyberpunk 2077 and then just copy the exact settings you see on your screen. Just a quick note, I am going to talk later about the mandatory role of max frame rate and vertical sync settings. For the moment being, leave them both off. Done with that, it's time to boost a bit the overall GPU performance using the MSI Afterburner and applying a mild overclock. Again, you will find the download link in the description and the installation is a very simple and quick procedure. Unless your card have already some kind of hardware problem or is covered with a blanket of dust, these overclocking settings are quite safe. Now it's time to run the game and make the final adjustments. Mind that my optimization goal is to offer the smoothest gameplay experience at the highest possible graphics fidelity. This is, I believe, the best way to experience a single-player game like Cyberpunk 2077, powered by a GTX 1660 Super. My first recommendation is the one you see right now on your screen. It is the ideal setup for high fidelity. 1080 resolution, maximum FPS enabled at 45 frames. I will try to keep it short here, so just pause the video whenever you need it, copy the settings you see, and then press apply. Before you jump into the game, open the NVIDIA control panel, enable the max frame rate and type the value 45. Browse a bit down and on the vertical sync, select fast. Now everything is ready to enjoy the beautifully made dystopian world of Cyberpunk 2077, free of frame stutters or skittering and at high video settings. Here is a side-by-side comparison of our setup with the preset high settings. The latter has a slightly fuzzy and somewhat blurry picture in comparison with the crystal clear graphics of our setup. On the best of all, both settings are offering the same FPS performance despite the visual quality differences. Allow me to say, not shabby at all for our 45 FPS setup. My second proposition is for those that they are obsessed with the numbers and they feel that no game should be played under the minimum 60 FPS. In this case, if you play on a 60Hz monitor, all you have to do is to type 60 on max frame rate section and enable the vertical sync at NVIDIA control panel. Select adaptive half refresh rate if you own a 120Hz monitor. In game settings, keep everything the same except the VSync that you have to choose the value of 60, and from the graphics tab you have to enable the FSR 2.0 at ultra quality and image sharpening at 0.5. Press apply and enjoy once again a buttery smooth gameplay with a slightly worse video quality than my original setup. You might also want to watch some other awesome GPU optimization videos I have made for you and consider the possibility of supporting my work by leaving a like if you like, subscribe if you haven't done so already, and press the notification bell if you don't want to miss the next upcoming videos. Regardless, thanks for watching and see you on the next one.